Right, give me one second, man. I got to give a shout out, man, to DRB Productions, streaming services, sound and lighting production, special event services. That is DRB underscore productions underscore 101 on Instagram. Dave Backer, the owner, you can give him a phone call at 702-580-4962. Make sure you email him at drbproductions101@gmail.com for all your streaming services needs. Once again, that streaming services, sound and lighting production, special event services. So I'm talking about if you got a church service that you need to be streamed live.
Just play it after this.
That you need to be. I also want to give a shout out to my good sponsor. You feel me? Your Way Restaurant, man. I'm drinking my good water out this good old. My good water out this good old mug, man. I appreciate y'all for the sponsorship, man. Y'all go check out Your Way restaurant. They serve breakfast and lunch right down Lake Meaning Jones right here in Las Vegas, Nevada, right behind the Walgreens and next door to Capriati's. But look, man, they serve breakfast and lunch. Bomb food. My favorite is the breakfast potatoes and the gravy. Whew, ain't had no good gravy over my breakfast potatoes in a minute. So I'm very thankful for that. Pancakes, man, they homemade, so that's bomb. Of course, you get the omelets, you know what I mean, and you get your food your way, the way you want it. They serve lunch as well. They got the good nachos with the Doritos. You know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about, like, homemade, you feel me? They also got the vegan option, so if you're a vegan, you can get the good old, basically a vegetable taco. You know what I'm saying? My wife had it, loved it, and that chicken patty melt or the beef patty melt, my favorite, so. Make sure y'all tap in to Your Way Restaurant right on Lake Meaning Jones for my sponsorship. Man, go tell them Hot Seat with IC Jonez sent you. Now, let's.
Hey, look, we up in here now, so we ain't got time to be playing.
I'm playing?
Are you down?
What's going on? What's going on? It's your main man. It's your boy, IC Jonez. Welcome to another episode of Hot Seat with IC Jonez right here on Room Service Radio. You know how it go, man. I'm live every Thursday and Friday, 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. That is Pacific Standard Time because people watching all over the world. You feel me? So, yeah, man, I'm excited to be here. Been a long week already, man. It ain't even over yet, but welcome to Friday. This week, Room Service Radio, we were at Agenda, the fashion trade show, right there at Bally's, Caesars Entertainment, right there on Las Vegas Boulevard and Flamingo. It was crazy. I'm talking about vendors from all over America, some great, great clothing, great pieces. Independent retailers, some major ones too. I seen Fila was in the building, you know what I mean? Coogi was in the building. But I got to meet the great man, Waka Flocka Flame, you know what I'm saying? And real down to earth, real cool dude. He is how he acts on television. So there's no acting with him. This is like really who he is. Real humble, you know what I mean? Good energy, good vibe. And I got to really chop it up with him. And I said, man, I just want to ask three questions. If I can get close to Waka, man, I just want to ask three questions. With me being in media, broadcasting, I got to do that. You know what I'm saying? And I said, man, Waka, what is your purpose today? What fulfills you today in your life? And where did you get the name Waka Flocka Flame? And did you drop the flame? Because, you know, we call them Waka Flocka, but it's still Waka Flocka Flame, just so you know. And for those answers, go check it out on my Instagram or go check it out on my Facebook. Run them numbers up. Run them views up for me. I also got to meet Soulja Boy. Big Draco was in the building. It was almost a rumble in the jungle in the building. You know, he got about 15 people walking with him. You know what I'm saying? And after K-Fly and Big Boo interviewed them, this other guy, Tone Trump, they were coming, you know, to cross paths. So Tone Trump was getting up and here comes Soulja to sit down. And somebody in Soulja's camp, they say he's an informant, allegedly, skinny from the nine. So Tone Trump was like, yo, you a rat, man. You put away a good man, man. It's because of you. And it was just like, whoa, like room service radio ain't got nothing to do with that. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't a setup. I promise it wasn't a setup because we didn't know. But that was like crazy. And it's just always some drama with Big Draco. And he like, I air this out and all this other stuff. I got bullets. And like, come on, bros. Come on, man. Come on, man. So we finally got it all settled. And, you know, me and Love, like, we all went out and just like, yo, chill, man. This is a business. And not only that, it's a black business, bro. Like, don't do that to our brand. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't care about your viral moment. I don't care about, you know, how it hurts your pride or whatever. Like, and, you know, the other guy, he wants to walk away peacefully, but he also started it by talking that talk. You know, you could have waited any other time outside of being in front of our broadcasting system. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, guys, keep the peace, man. Chill out, bros. And they did. So then the homies got to interview Soulja Boy, Big Draco, and I got a chance to ask him a question. How did you enjoy the versus battle with Bow Wow? And here he go with the Lit Pee Wee. You mean Lit Pee Wee? Come on, man. So anyway, we had fun. I did get a drop from him for Room Service Radio. He's dropping his clothing, you know, SODMG this fall, he says. So be on the lookout for Soulja Boy, Big Draco, and his clothing line. Waka Flocka has two lines. He has Skrit and he has Dro. We got to interview JB, the owner of Dro, which is dope. And who else, man? Mr. Fab was in the building. So if y'all don't know, he's an Oak Town legend. You feel me? He knows some of everybody, got songs with some of everybody. Got to sit down with him. We had a real dope conversation, Boo and I. And man, just good energy as well. And like his goals and like his mindset. And he's a serial entrepreneur. So, you know, that'll be up soon. I got a little, you know, 4-minute clip about that. And just everything he got going on, you know. So for all of the good things that happened at the Agenda Trade Show, check out my Instagram, check out my Facebook, run them numbers up, run them views up. I'm excited because now I get to add that to my resume, that these are some of the great people that I was able to interview, some of the great people that I have on camera, and they are a part of my brand now, Hot Seat with IC Jonez, and I'm very thankful. Shout out to Bear Truth. Shout out to Dice City, you know what I mean? Shout out Gold, you feel me? He hooked me up with the shirt. Shout out to number one draft pick. They shot me some stuff, man. I Got Hustle. Shout out I Got Hustle. KO Hustle. Thank you, brother. Man, I can't name them all, bro. It was too many to name, man. But I interviewed some great... Oh, Forever Loyal. King over there, Forever Loyal. Appreciate it, man. Just a lot in 2 days. Then we went to Dre's. They gonna have the after party. Really? The first day? It was 2 days, and you're going to have the after party at Dre's at 10 o'clock. Doors open at 10. And then it wasn't over till like 4 or 5 in the morning. So I left early. I left at like 2:30, something like that. But, man, I struggled Thursday morning. It was a struggle. So please, next time, if you're watching Agenda, please, because y'all tapped in with me. Thank you for tapping in with me. Please don't have the private party in between the first 2 days, please. Because the first day of having an after party is just crazy, man. Because we had a long day. You're talking about from 8:30 to 5. Then 10 o'clock to 2 a.m. Then you got to be back up there at 8:30. And then it's over again. And then you got to break down. Then you got to set back up. Come on, man. Y'all knew better. Y'all knew better. But I did, too. I should have stayed at home. I shouldn't have went out. So now that I got that out the way, man, I want to say to my wife, happy anniversary. Our anniversary is this weekend. 11 years married, man. 15 years together. It's an amazing thing to be with the same person for so long, because I've seen a lot of divorces. I've seen a lot of separation in our time of being together. You know, I've only seen a few people that are lasting as long as us. And so, love you a lot. And I can't wait till we hit the plane and go to Miami this weekend. First time in Miami. I think it's going to be dope. So, yes, your boy is in the building. Hot Seat with IC Jonez, Room Service Radio. Deacon T is here. We're going to have the hot topic today. You already know how I go. Words of wisdom. He got an assistant with him today, Lil Nasir. You know what I mean? And I want to appreciate right now, send my appreciation to the homie I Am Light in the building. He brought my special guest through today. Mr. Perfect is here today. What's happening with it, man?
What's up with you?
Man, feeling good. How about you?
Oh, I'm feeling real good.
That's right, man. What kind of phone you got?
LG dual screen.
Okay, so I'm able to give you the regular plug-in so you can play your music when it's time, right?
Okay, yep.
Yeah, yeah. If not, I got it. I definitely got it. We are streaming live. You know, we do Facebook, we do YouTube, we do Instagram, we do some of everything. And I'm just letting y'all know so y'all can tell a friend to tell a friend, share, like, comment. We live right now on these platforms. So tell me about yourself, man. Where you come from? Where you hailing from?
I'm born and raised right here in Las Vegas.
Word.
Yeah.
Yeah. How was it for you growing up here?
Wild.
Wild.
Wow. I mean, I ain't going to say, you know, I had it the hardest, but I ain't have it the best. So being right there in the middle in Las Vegas, you got a bit of everything going on.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Is there a certain side, west side, east side, south side?
West side.
West side. Mm-hmm. We talking Lake Mead, MLK, west side?
Yeah.
Oh.
And further up, all the way
yeah.
up.
Smoke yeah. Ridge, Rainbow, west
all
side?
Way up. Yeah. All the way up.
That's my stomping grounds right there, man. So what's going on, man? What, you know, did you go through high school doing music or?
Well, I started with I Am Light when we was kids.
Word. That's your brother.
Yeah, and I kind of did it on and off. And then recently, in 2018, I was in prison.
How long, you said?
Like 2018.
To when?
Ooh, okay. So I went in 15. I got
okay.
out 18.
15 to 18. 2.5, 3 years.
Yeah. And that was my last bit. But I was in there, and my boy Rich, shout out to Rich, we in the cell, and I'm just rapping some of my old music.
Mm-hmm.
And he finally just told me, he said, what is you doing, bro?
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, well, I'm fighting bank robbery. I don't know when I'm getting out.
Mm-hmm.
So right now I'm doing this time.
Mm-hmm.
And
just come up closer to the mic for me.
He said, nah, man, you got to get back in that booth. He bought me a journal. He said, I need you to fill that up.
Mm-hmm.
And I did that, and ever since then, it's just been what it is.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm on. I mean, it's a struggle because you're chasing a passion. So you still got to pay your bills. You still
yes.
got to take care of your kids. So.
Yes.
But, yeah, it's time now. The time is now.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So tell me about your brand.
Okay. The Hip Hop Hippie. That's just what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Love, peace, and happiness. I mm-hmm. come from the streets, you know, and I got a so happy story and a sad one, too. I'm a hippie, bro.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So that's my brand. And, Mr. Perfect comes from, because my mother was a God-fearing woman,
mm-hmm.
and I feel like everybody's perfect.
Mm.
So I took the name, because if nobody was perfect like we say,
mm-hmm.
I mean, God making a whole lot of mistakes.
Mm.
Every day he making one,
mm.
or two, or three.
Mm.
So that, you know, it's happiness, it's freedom with me.
Mm.
You know, I did a lot of time in the cage.
Mm-hmm.
So to be able to dissect that word freedom from financial to mental to spiritual,
mm-hmm.
that's my brain.
When did you start smoking weed?
When I was like 12.
12? Yeah. And you never stopped? I mean, outside of probably jail.
Parole and probation. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that type of stuff.
Yeah.
And then when that was done, you went right back to smoking
right
weed.
Back too.
Tell me what weed does for you. Marijuana.
It stabilizes me.
Okay.
Cause I'm a high energetic person,
mm-hmm.
so if I don't calm myself down, I'm gonna be 100 miles an hour,
mm-hmm.
and I'm impulsive.
Yeah.
So moving off pure impulse, that ain't safe.
Right.
Yeah, so right. it stabilized.
Who introduced you at 12 to some weed?
My big sister.
Okay. Tell me that story. What happened?
I mean, so me and my little cousin, we was bad. Mm-hmm. And my sister and my cousin was smoking a joint. And they, like, had an idea in their head. They was going to calm us down.
Okay. Yeah. Wow.
And it just made us laugh for the rest of the
day. But you calm yourself down, though. You wasn't ripping the Reddit. Right. Yeah. I did the same thing. I started smoking weed when I was 12. I don't smoke weed anymore, but when I did, man, it was a neighbor. You know, my cousins smoked weed already or whatever, but I never smoked weed. So I'm in the garage and she's smoking. She's like 16 or something. I think she's like 3 or 4 years older than me. And a couple of my other friends. And so we in the garage. And I'm like, let me go ahead and try it. You know what I mean? At least it ain't my family. You know what I'm saying? Boy, I was high as all get out. And you know, you gotta wait to calm down to go home. You know, your eyes red, you smell like weed. So, but we had fun that day. And then ever since then, I began to smoke weed. So did you ever sell weed?
Yeah. The majority of my life.
How did you get into that?
My big brother.
Okay, tell me what happened.
I just watched him.
Okay.
And he was one of them dudes, so he was really moving.
Yeah.
And I just watched him, and now that's something. If I ever got to lean on something.
You got that.
I got that. That's a trade.
Right.
Like painting, plumbing, that's a trade.
How do you feel now that it is legal? Because when we was growing up, bro, I'd have had so many tickets for weed and jail time for weed, being pulled over with a sack on me. Now it's legal.
When it going legal, my cannabis dreams trying to get as big as my music dreams.
I got it. Got it.
Yeah, it's amazing, and on what they finding every day.
Yeah.
As far as these scientists behind it.
Right.
Okay. I love it.
Now the term hippie, right?
Mm-hmm.
When did you find out what a hippie was, and like attach yourself to it?
Okay, so I did my homework on what a hippie is.
Mm.
Caught a case in Montana. That's where I live right now as we speak.
Yeah.
And I did time out there.
Okay.
A lot of hippies.
Okay.
So I started intermingling with them.
Mm.
I might have been 10 black men in the whole prison.
Mm-hmm.
So I just started intermingling with the hippies.
Mm-hmm.
And the old ones, the young ones, I want to see the new school hippies. I want to see the old school hippies. That's when I started learning about Woodstock.
Mm-hmm.
Jimi Hendrix started talking to me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I did my homework on it. And when I seen what they stood for, I mean, they believe in living off your passions. How deep does that get?
Very.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And to really stand on love, peace, and happiness coming from somebody who come out to Herbert Gerson Projects.
Okay.
That's something like, come on, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it was just me. And then one of my idols being Mac Dre, I'm like, oh, this is where I'm supposed to be, right here.
Got it.
Yeah.
So are you an 80s baby or a 90s baby?
80s.
80s baby.
Yeah.
Herbert Gerson Projects.
Yeah.
Lake Me MLK.
Yeah.
And right behind that was the Kerry Arms Projects.
Mm-hmm.
All that is the GPK area right there, man. That's crazy. I remember the projects as a young kid. A couple years back, I had a dream that it was still there. You know what I mean? Like I was on Lake Mead in between Comstock and MLK, and I was like riding a bike, and it was just crazy, like, because that was our projects, you know. Sadly, they tore it down. But guess what? I began to live in Whispering Timbers, which is the housing development that they built after they tore it down. You know what I mean? So it's just like, I'm attached to the West Side, man.
Yeah.
Like, that is my stomping grounds. That's where I was born, you know, where I was raised. And then, like you say, you go up Cary, you turn into Smoke Ranch, and all up and through there, you know?
Yeah.
From Rancho to MLK to Losi and J Street, Alphabet Streets and all of that. It's just like I'm attached. Like every time I come back home, like I got to see the West Side.
It's
you know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's a feeling. And I don't know. It's just home.
Exactly.
No matter how far I go away, like mm-hmm. that's home, you know?
Yeah.
How do you feel about the West Side?
I feel like as of right now, it's starting to lose its authenticity.
Mm-hmm.
Growing up as a kid, that energy ain't the same.
Mm-mm.
The pistols can pop as much as they want to. The energy of the people ain't the same.
Mm-hmm.
And now, I mean, you know, not trying to go to the skin color with it, but mm-hmm. we losing numbers on the West Side
mm-hmm.
now. So, I mean, I go there, I got my family, I go tap in, but to just go to the West Side to find something to get into, that ain't me.
It's not the same.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Shout out to Chef Carol Southern Kitchen on MLK.
And Madison, man, that food is so amazing. If you got time this weekend, you need to go to Chef Carol's Southern Kitchen, right by Iced Out Barbershop. Bro, if you like soul food, got that right. That's where it's at. Yeah. My dish is the grilled salmon with the double rice and gravy. They can keep, not that they can keep it that is bad, like I'm just a gravy. Have you heard my commercial? Like, but their greens, their yams, their mac and cheese, their cornbread, everything's smacking, bro. And that's the West Side. You feel me? No shot against nobody else that is doing their thing. That's just my place to be. So if you do that, if you do go to the West Side and go check on your family and everything, man, either you go or you take everybody, like, hey, man, IC Jonez said this is smacking. And then let me know. You feel me?
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, I don't like that there's a fast food restaurant on every corner on the West. Mm. There's no Fresh and Easy. I'm not saying that exists anymore. There's no Trader Joe's. You know what I mean? There's no Sprouts. You know, even like an Olive Garden. I don't know what you call those restaurants, but like, there's no Applebee's. And now those are affordable places to eat at for a low income community. They got the 2 for $25s and, you know, those type of deal meals. No, there's a Panda over there. There's a Taco Bell. There is a McDonald's, a Jack in the Box, a Del Taco, a Starbucks, all in the same corner. Mm-hmm. And then there's a liquor store here, a liquor store there, a liquor store here. You know what I mean? A gas station. It's like, bro, it's still so much desert over there. Why can't someone understand we want better things?
Exactly. Don't make it look better. Make it better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, we shouldn't have to go to Summerlin for Sprouts. We shouldn't have to go to Centennial Hills for Trader Joe's. You know what I'm saying? Like, we shouldn't have to do that.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily live there, but my heart is there. And everybody always going to see me there because we give back there.
Yeah, that's the
rules. You feel me? But I want them to build better things for my people down there. You know what I mean?
Right.
So when it comes to being a black hippie, you are accepted because is there no color in being a hippie, or how does that work?
And that's exactly what it is. When you step into that community, you step as you are.
Mm-hmm.
It don't matter if you're black, white, purple, or blue.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just, it's about the vibe. It's about that energy.
Yeah.
I mean, Woodstock, you had, what they have, over 2 million people?
Wow.
Not a fight.
Wow.
You couldn't even put 2 million Christians together right now without it jumping off.
Come closer.
You know what I'm saying? And to me, that's beautiful.
Yeah,
that's
yeah. I like that.
Yeah.
It's true. It's very true, man. So what's up with the presence on social media? How you feel about social media today, bros?
I think it's magic.
Okay.
You know, comparing to even how we had to sell weed back in the day. You got to get on the block. I'm watching these youngsters get on Snapchat and get it cracking.
Right.
And I'm like, wow.
Putting it on a story.
Yeah. And then when I first jump into it, I didn't even know what a DM was. I'm giving people my phone number in the comment.
On the comment. Yeah, 80s baby for sure.
But when I'm now seeing they directing traffic.
Mm-hmm. It's crazy.
Directing traffic.
So it's magic. Yeah. So will you... Because your page is private, right?
Yeah. So I'm going to open it all up.
Yeah.
Yeah, we in the lab with all that right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
So where are you growing and growing to? Can you talk to us about that?
So today we got a video shoot, and that's when I'm introducing my image.
Okay.
Hippie from the hood.
Okay.
And from there, I just got to keep it coming. I'm going to keep coming with videos. I'm going to keep coming with music, and I just got to go.
Right.
If I got to beat my feet and get on the Greyhound bus to go make sure them boys in Washington hear about me, then that's what I'm going to do.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a grinder. So
you have to.
I'm going to grind it out.
Who were you before this?
Ooh, a nutcase. I'm going to put it this way. If I wish I can get I Am Light over here to tell you that question, but I was a criminal. That's just what it is. I was a criminal. If you look at my criminal history, I'm not what you call a D-boy. I'm not what you call a pimp. I'm not what you call a robber. If you look at my criminal history, it's a little bit of everything in there.
Yeah, you said bank robbery.
Yeah, I'm
just, were you with some ignorant people where you got caught?
No, by myself.
So it just had to happen, basically.
Yeah.
Had to get.
And of course, getting the handcuffs put on you is some of the worst stuff that can happen to you. But that particular time, that was probably the best thing that ever happened to me.
Yeah. A lot of times it is a surreal moment. Go ahead, talk to me.
I had to brainwash myself and recondition myself.
Yeah.
Because who I was wasn't it, and it wasn't going to lead nowhere. But back in those days on the ground, so I had to make that decision.
Yeah.
And stand on it. And it take, when you make a life-altering decision like that, it take work.
Give me this right here. Thank you.
It take work.
It does. It absolutely does. I want to
congratulate you on changing your life.
Thank you, buddy.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's not every day, and it's not easy that a man can change his life, let alone a black man, but a man in general, you know, with no color attached to it. It's not easy for men to change their lives. Mm-hmm. You've been in prison. Mm-hmm. You've seen the many of men who are hard-headed,
yeah,
repeat offenders, people who want to stay in there, who just are institutionalized. You've seen all these things. Mm-hmm. People who do things on purpose to get three hots in a cot and all that stuff.
Yeah.
You've seen it. Mm-hmm. So for you to change your life, I congratulate you.
Thank you.
Because it's real.
Yeah.
And you black.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So if the odds are stacked against you, they actually tell you when you leave, we'll see you again.
All the time.
You feel me?
Yeah.
I will see you again.
Yeah.
Really. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it's like something they try to condition you to feel like this is who I am.
Yep.
I am a felon. So what is it worth? When I get on these streets, man, what I'ma do? Exactly. I don't know nothing better. All of those things is what they try to condition you. How was it for you in prison? Were the guards on your helmet, or did life change for you and it was cool, no problems? How was it?
Every time was different. I mean, I was raised well, so as far as MCOs is concerned, I respected them as long as they kept it respectful with me. And since I carried myself that way, if I did start acting up, everybody else knew I was bothered. You know, because I mind my business. My best formula in prison was I was cool with everybody, but I ain't mess with nobody. I did my own time.
Cool with everybody, but yeah, didn't mess with nobody.
And that's what I do.
Did your own time.
Mm-hmm.
Man, look, we're going to get into this Hippie from the Hood track. Is this even out yet?
It will be here in a few hours.
All right, cool. Yep, so we're going to keep the cameras rolling.
Okay.
You can rap to it or whatever. We're just going to react to it. You feel me? And I want you to introduce it right now.
This is Hippie from the Hood. And go ahead, tune in, listen.
Mr. Perfect.
Mr. Perfect, talking to him.
Hot Seat with IC Jonez, Room Service Radio. Let's go. It's already that Mac Dre feel right now.
Mushroom sex with some cushy get by. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Acid tripping, but I'm still hella fly. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Mushroom sex with some cushy get by. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Acid tripping, but I'm still hella fly. Little leprechauns running, trying to lead me to the go. Me and my bitch on the Galloway crow. Marshes on the block and they all on go. Spaceships floating, coming out of the smoke. Dance to the tune, see cartoons. Still the flash nigga when I step up in the room. Speakers on boom, cars on zoom. Got so high that I landed on the moon. When I'm off the X-Men, all I do is get
okay.
Front seat head swinging, flicking off the pits. Never gave a fuck about a funky ass bitch. Stay fucked up, cause I'm young, fly, rich. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Mushroom sex with some push to get by. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Acid tripping, but I'm still hella fly. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Mushroom sex, good to get by. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Acid tripping, but I'm still hella fly. I'm on another planet where everything glows.
What?
Room full of bad bitches, everything goes. What kind of hoes? Everything snow. Blow big bomb, nigga, everything draw. Mouth full of gold in a V-wagon bus. Tie-dye beer, cast peace signs us. A fairy just flew past, hit me with the dust. Woo. Then a little green man, big gun bust. Trippin', 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 trippin'. Let me hit the white little calm down trip. make sense, so I'm not trying to listen. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Mushrooms, ecstasy, push it, get high. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Acid tripping, but I'm still on the fly. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Mushrooms, ecstasy, push it, get high. I'm a hippie from the hood and I like to get high. Acid tripping, but I'm still on the fly. Let me break it down to you just like this. It's like a fart in the shower when I spit hot shit. Got flame on the brain when it hit that wick. Sparks get to flying like a curved out clip. Me, Scooby-Doo and Nemo hanging out. Taz in the trunk and he straight banging out. My nigga Richard Damo and he stay flamed up. I'm a hippie from the hood and I'm straight banged out. I'm living, y'all dying. I'm rolling, I'm fine. On top, I'm up, I'm float, I'm flying. Love, sex, and drugs if you know my kind. This my life, I like to blow my mind. From the hood and I like to get high. What? Hippie from the hood and I like to get high. What? Hippie from the hood and I like to get high. What? Hippie from the hood and I like to get high.
They wasn't ready for that one.
Nope. Welcome.
They wasn't looking for
that. Bring that energy in, man.
They ain't tell me no. No.
Psychedelics now. Yeah. See them colors wavy?
Yeah.
Everything in 3D. So I've heard.
Yeah.
Hey. I'm scared to take psychedelics, man.
I was too for a long time.
Real, bro.
Ooh, I was scared to death.
You know?
And then I just a taste of it, I was like, oh.
It's flowing.
This real life right here. Like you said,
yeah.
3D, that
yeah.
HD TV, what I call it. As soon as my hot kick in, they go to HD.
Wow.
4th of July, I looked in the sky. Oh, shit.
What is the come down on that? Is it acid or which one?
With mushrooms there okay. isn't. With acid, sometimes it's not hard like X or nothing like that. Mm. But the psychedelics ain't a hard come down like a junkie. You know what I mean?
Mm.
Like them junkies come down.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But it's not like that. Mushrooms, I can still eat and sleep.
Yeah.
You know, I'm fine. I might get some cotton mouth, like some weed. But
right.
other than that, I'm straight.
I'm going to go to a music break, you know what I mean? But I'm enjoying the energy.
Absolutely.
Good vibe, fam.
Me too.
You know what I'm saying? Thank you for allowing me in your life, but also the people that's going to be watching this later and the people that's watching right now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is a real life story. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I want to get into a little bit more. You
okay.
feel me? So take a little break. We'll be back. After this, Hot Seat with IC Jonez on Room Service Radio. We got Mr. Perfect in the building.
Yeah.
now, baby, I ain't got no patience. Gotta say something, somehow on top of waiting. How to make a smile, baby, ain't no hesitation. She ain't getting paid, not no altercations. If you ain't the same, then she making alterations. In my mind, what I'm gon' say, boy, I'm pacing. Trying to find my lives, preparations. Baby, pop this perky, cause you know we getting faded for real. Scared, but you wanna twerk. She wanna bust it, hold on, let me see you work. She just wanna twerk. Scared, scared, designer on her shoes and designer on her skirt. Scared, scared, but you wanna twerk. She wanna bust it, hold on, let me see you work. She just wanna twerk. Scared, scared, designer on her shoes and designer on her skirt.
What's going on, man? We back at it like we never left, man. I'm thankful for my playlist. Thankful for everybody rocking with your boy on the playlist, man. Hot Seat with IC Jonez every Thursday and Friday, 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. right here on Room Service Radio. Don't forget, Kicking It with Jonez and Skinny every Tuesday, 3 to 5. We coming back. We are coming back. Really, really soon, man. It's been a lot going on with Code 7. Been a lot going on with IC Jonez. You know what I mean? So, but we committed to do Kicking It with Jonez and Skinny, and we're going to keep going forward. Man, they had a kickball game. It was hip-hop with Lou versus Code 7 right there at Craig Ranch. It was an amazing, amazing night, man. Code 7 took home the W. It's going to be a rematch real soon. I'm putting together my team, so if you want to be on Hot Seat with IC Jonez kickball team, DM me, leave a message in the comments, holla at me, either way it go. Let's see if you got what it takes to bring home the W for Hot Seat with IC Jonez. All right, man, we back. We got the black hippie. We got the hippie from the hood. We got Mr. Perfect. So, man, let's go back a little bit. You said you lost your mom.
Yeah.
How long ago was that?
In March.
This year?
Mm-hmm.
Man, my condolences.
Thank you.
How she passed?
She had a knee surgery, and she came home. She was home for about a week, and she had a blood clot, and it traveled to her lung.
Knee surgery, mm-hmm. Blood clot, traveled to lung.
Yes.
She was at home?
Yes.
So couldn't get to the hospital in time.
Well, the paramedics got there, but I don't think they checked her for a blood clot like they were supposed to.
Wow.
Yeah, because they knew she was fresh out of surgery, so they were supposed to check for a blood clot immediately.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, are y'all pursuing anything?
Yeah, my sister kind of in that department handling business.
Nice, man. How many siblings you got?
Two.
Two siblings. Was that an older brother?
Older brother and older sister.
Okay. So how did that affect you this year, man? Because I know you feel like she wasn't supposed to go.
Definitely.
It was knee surgery.
Definitely.
It wasn't supposed to happen like
it
that.
It was unexpected. Me and my mother was extremely close. So, I mean, initially, I didn't know what I was going to do without her.
Mm.
And so I started really paying attention to my energy and my thoughts. Because I didn't want to fly off the handle.
Mm.
I can easily do that. So I just told myself, once again, back to that decision, to channel my energy towards what she would want me to channel it towards.
Mm.
My dreams and handling my businesses and men.
Yeah.
And immediately, that's what I did. Immediately.
Channeling it.
So now me and my niece and my sister, we got a t-shirt business about to jump off, Bible to the T. It's a t-shirt for every book of the Bible.
Wow.
And this is pushing for my mom's. Like I said, she's big in the Church and God in Christ.
Wow.
Serious.
Kojic, baby.
And so we working on that, and that's, and I'm gonna keep my mom alive with it, you know.
What was your mother's name?
Veronica. Yeah.
Man. And
the initial mother company for that is Veronica's Empire LLC.
Yes.
So, and we can finna jump it off.
Rest in heaven,
mm-hmm.
Veronica, man. Music for you. I know you said you got the journal when you was in the pen and everything, mm-hmm. But when did your musical journey start?
I think my musical journey started when the first time I picked up a pen and wrote a bar. When I learned how to, because now you've taken it back all the way to the end. And I remember when I couldn't even, I didn't know how to count my bars.
Yes.
Or I didn't even know how to calculate my bars or the difference between a hook and a bridge.
Yes.
And I was learning little bits and pieces from other rappers throughout the years.
Right.
And then I started learning about my delivery and ad-libs. And so the journey started at the first composition book. And that was 14, 15.
Nice. 14, 15 years old. And you go from there to bank robbery.
Yeah.
What happened?
So I know you get a lot of dudes that'd be like, you know, I grew up a certain kind of way, so the streets chose me. That wasn't me. I chose the streets. This is what I wanted, was the streets. And it was nothing cooler to me than to be a Herbert Gershon, a pimp, and just the Macklemores, bro. I'm a Macklemore. So you being from Vegas, you know what that name carries. So those are my idols. The Mikes and the Stacys was my idols. So then I had my mom, a God-fearing woman that's dragging me down to church, making me go to school. And, you know, and this is, was the who really wanted the best for me.
But
what she was directing me towards, I guess, at that point in time, it wasn't enough excitement.
Was it? Yeah, it wasn't appealing.
Yeah.
So wasn't fast enough.
I think that's what it was. And then, you know, I was the baby. So I'm watching my sister and brother grow into their adultism, find they self. But this is who I'm in the house with every day. This is my idols. So I don't, I really don't know what just made me go off the handle like that. But yeah, I don't like to hold my nuts neither, but I'm talented. I can draw. I can, you know, I'll pick up a paintbrush, what you want to do. And when I say art, I like art. I'll pick up a tattoo gun, anything. So, and I always just play my talents to the left. I just played them to the left. I use my talents when I get locked up. That's when I started drawing and writing albums. And Hippie from the Hood, I drew in a prison cell.
You know, the word talks about burying talent. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know that.
Yes.
But I'm glad you dug them up.
Yeah.
Right? How much of that are you able to talk about? Because you did your time, right? And you paid your debt to society or however they say it. Tell me about how you riled up to that. Like, was it like something easy? Let me say this too first, right? So, rest in peace to the Nevada Highway Patrolman that passed away, right? There was one that passed away in a high-speed chase recently, last month, July.
Yeah.
He was putting down the strip, the spike strips, and boom, right? Didn't die instantly or nothing, died in the hospital, right? I said all that to bring you to, we're on the freeway, me and my wife, we're coming on the 215 from my doctor's appointment, way out in Green Valley. Bro, the freeway on the other end is packed with every police officer from Metro that you can think of. From the trucks to the cars to the motorcycle, everybody. And my wife was like, this is a perfect time to rob a bank. All these police officers are on the freeway.
Yeah.
And then we got to think logical, well, Northtown's still available. And you don't want to mess with Northtown, right?
So nobody wanted with Northtown.
Nobody wanted with Northtown. So I'm like, yeah, you think that. Like, it's just like a thought, like, we could rob a bank if, you know, all of them are out here or whatever. So what was your thought to think you could do it and get away?
Federal prison. So I went to prison for ex-felon possession of a firearm.
Okay.
And when I went to the feds, I'm seeing these dudes come in and they robbing banks with notes and, you know, and.
Oh, like give the note to the people and they quiet and.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm like, wow. And these dudes is getting like 5 pieces. They getting like 5 years.
Yeah.
Well, off these guns I'm fighting, everybody telling me I'm getting 5 years. And I just was laying in my cell one night and was like, well, I think it'd make more sense to rob a bank than to carry a gun if ain't nobody looking for me. Now, that was back 2010.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how I looked at it. And then when I got locked up, I don't know if it was the law of attraction and where my mind went right there, but every sophisticated bank robber ended up in my circle.
Oh, my God.
And it was nothing but a motivational speech every day. And when I got out, I didn't have it on my mind. I promise you I didn't. And I got out and I got in a situation. And just like selling weed, I felt like I could fall back on that. You know what? I done did enough homework. Let's go.
Mm-hmm.
And I went.
Mm.
By myself.
Mm. Alone.
Yeah.
They came swarming there, or was it later?
When I left the bank, yeah, I was gone. And I was in Montana. And the people who was going to hide me out got scared. So now I'm in a town that I don't know nobody, like a chicken with my head cut off, trying to figure out what's my next move. Because I can't go home. That's too close to the bank.
Yeah.
So, yeah, the inevitable happened. And, yeah, before you know it, I looked around and I was surrounded.
Surrounded. Mm-hmm. Queen and Slim, you ever seen that movie?
Mm-mm.
Oh, man. I ain't going to tell you anything. You got to watch it.
Okay.
It ain't a bank robbery or nothing, but they thought they were going to be able to, you know, trust the people all the way to where they get on the plane and go to wherever they're supposed to go. That last dude turned on them for the reward money.
Mm.
He was already, you know, he had money. You know what I mean? I think he even got some money to do that situation for them.
Yeah.
Still told on them for the bigger bag. It was sad.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you always think something and you feel like you think it all the way through. And once, and that's why I know you did it by yourself. Once you involve others, you do not know what they will or won't do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So thank you for going deep with me on that.
Absolutely.
You're in the hot seat with IC Jonez, man. I got to ask those questions because it's just on me. And if I didn't, I'd be like, damn, man, he was so cool. I think I could have asked him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so instead I ask and a person could tell me, yeah, we're not going to go that. Or you could tell me, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I very much appreciate that. Is there any music out there from you previously that we can listen to?
I haven't dropped nothing. I got so much music in my vault is what I like to call it. But I have to strategically do this right.
Okay.
So I didn't want to just go, you know, I got buddies that rap and that think that that's all this game is about. And to drop something on SoundCloud 3 times a day.
Mm-hmm.
I can't do that. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, please believe me, though, we coming with a follow-up and we going to come hard.
Okay. I'm very thankful to my bro, I Am Light, for believing in both of us.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? He gave you the alley-oop. And he said he coming soon. You feel me? I'm just thankful for my platform for this to be even available for cats who, you ain't even got no catalog right now. You know what I mean? That people can listen to.
Exactly.
And you in the hot seat. You feel me?
Yeah.
But the proper channels were touched on to get you in the hot seat. You know what I mean? So I want people to know, like, when you do the proper things, you can be in the hot seat because it's not about your fame. It's not about your status. I want to talk to everybody as long as they go through the proper channels to get in this seat. And he did that. You know what I mean? Yeah. So keep him on your team.
Absolutely.
I know y'all been friends since 10.
Since we was 10.
10 years old.
Yeah.
So he ain't going nowhere.
No.
You know what I mean?
I tried to get rid of him before I could.
That's what I was saying, right? In friendships, do we not get into it with each other?
Oh, yeah.
Do we not always see eye to eye? Especially somebody since you was 10.
Mm-hmm.
That's a real relationship.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to tell people, like, stop falling out with your folks. You know what I'm saying? Like, even if you go through something, holler at them in a month or two. You know what I mean? When you finish it. And sometimes you'll be like, what the heck was we talking about? Like, what was we tripping over? Oh, man. And growth can happen in 60 days.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? A lot could happen in 22 days.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? From what I heard, you think about the same thing 22 days or you do the same thing for 22 days, something like that.
Habit.
Becomes habit. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, I know.
You feel me? So, you know, when you talk about friendships, man, I get tired of people trying to fall out over, like, stuff that could be talked about as human beings.
Absolutely.
Whether you two females, two males, male, female, whether you boyfriend, girlfriend, or in a relationship, it doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. You don't have to fall out. and they don't have to be enemies. And even if y'all don't speak, stop speaking down on people and becoming enemies. There's no need for that.
Exactly.
You following me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, so you rock with that?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Man. Having a friend since you was 10. Not to say I know how old you are, but when you say 80s baby and then you know somebody since you was 10, like you've been through some life.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And you've been through life with him. You feel me? So keep that guy on your team, man. He got your back like almost like a mini manager, like a cool assistant right now.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Putting you in the game, coach. And man, just take my condolences, man. Seriously. This year I lost two little cousins. And it was crazy because I lost them back to back. One was 6 years old, one was 18 years old. Neither one of them got to live out their life. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, bro. And both of them passed away in the hospital. So there was nothing money could do. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like even if we had $30 million, like each one of my family members had $1 million and we was able to put in, like, there was nothing money could buy.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And it's sad because we always be thinking that's going to change stuff. It's just like, sometimes it's just how it works out.
Yeah.
Last year, I lost my aunt, which was their grandmother. You know what I mean? And then I lost my grandfather and I lost my nephew. He was 16. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, like, I've been through it. So, when I give you my condolences, it's real because, bro, you just don't know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it's hard. So, you know, is there anything that you can tell people? Because I know you kind of went over it about losing a loved one, especially someone like a mother at your age.
Man, you got to stay strong. You have to pay attention to your thoughts. I'm talking about every thought. And channel your energy constructively. And that's the only thing I can really say, because when people say, you know, they understand and this, that, and the other, I mean, they can to a certain extent, but their relationship with their mother wasn't the same as your relationship with yours.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so there is nobody in that situation with you. You are alone, you know, and that's something you got to deal with.
Yeah.
You know, so you just got to stay strong. You have to prize your joy. You have to, anything positive about yourself, cherish that.
Right.
Because if you don't, everything else going to leak in.
Facts. Do me a favor, y'all, follow him, King Solomon LV. He's revamping some stuff. So if you follow him now, you know, you can, you know, stay attached to what he's going to invent going forward. You feel me? And that song is coming soon. Hippie from the Hood.
Yes.
Y'all shooting a video today.
Absolutely.
From Hugh View, which is my partner, Will Willie, man. 100. All right, so we about to go on a break. And when we come back, we're going to have Deacon T's Hot Topics. So be ready for some words of wisdom. It's going up in a major way on Hot Seat with IC Jonez, Room Service Radio. You know how I go, man. See you on the other side in the 1 o'clock hour. We're going to have Showtime Ken in the building. Let's go.
Okay. Yeah. Let's get it.
This is the way that I end. I have no limits when pushing my hand. Shit that I write it, get under their skin. They gonna feel it like right on their hand. I will not stop until I'm in the hurt. I'm clocking in and you getting this word. You ain't gotta tell a nigga nothing, you been frontin'. You ain't never seen it coming when a nigga get the bustin' with a light skinny nigga on the net with the bag with the brand new suit and the blue suede shoes with the buckles on. Looking like I got a, and you looking like a, I don't fuck with 12. All of these cops and these streets trying to kill us, but we won't stay silent, we making that. We stand up for what we believe in, we fighting for freedom, and this is a choice. And I have a voice. I said, what I want? You want you some smoke? Go get you a gun. Cause I ain't got time for all of these stunts. You stop for the grand. I chill with the hand. And I am a man. Stand on my own 2 feet. 10 toes down and a better in the heat. When the last time you heard a nigga at the bay with a ride so cold, make a head just switch lane like,
ooh, who was the air? Flow was so rare.
You must be one of a kind like, ooh, please just be there. You can't compare. You just be wasting your time like, ooh, you in despair. Get you a chair. You just, how you see? Ooh, you think you broke? This is a show. All of you fuckers asleep. All of you fuckers asleep. All of you fuckers.
And I'm about
about to wake them all up. Cause everybody dealing with some trauma. PTSD and the ADHD is a real thing, and I seen it first hit. My plan is to get us all together tonight and take flight and fight for what's right. Your life is unlike my life, but your life can shed some light on the people that can't fight for their rights. Like, yeah, flow so rare. He must be
one of a kind. Like,
ooh, please just be here. You can't compare. You just be wasting your time. Like, ooh, you in despair. Get you a chair. You need to have you see. Ooh, you think you woke? This is a joke. All of you fuckers asleep. All of you fuckers asleep. All of you fuckers. Who was that air? Flowing so rare. You must be one of a kind. Like, ooh, please just be here. You can't compare. You just be wasting your time. Like, ooh, you in despair. Get you a chair. Get you there. How you see? Ooh, you think you woke? This is a all of you fuckers asleep. And I'm about to wake them all up. Yeah. And I'm about to wake them all up.
That's more deceiving. More power, they won't let it go. They figure they get your soul, it's worth more than gold. Put wool over your eyes, they got mind control. We all staring at our screens in a sea full of people. We all drown to the sounds of the screams of our evil. Now that's a scary scene compared to what's really seen. We all getting over, get away with everything. Trying to live American dreams and wanting better things. It's to the point where we kill and be killed. Kill at will, kill Bill. Kill to be real, cold steel. Turn hot, stirring the pot. Act nervous, get shot. They carry concealed. Need to be still before you get popped and murdered by a cop. Trying to kill us out here.
5G, coronavirus.
Hey look, they trying to kill us out here.
Illuminati, devil, big pharma.
They trying to kill us out here.
I mean, they even got us against us. Us versus the government.
Hey look, they trying to kill us out here.
It's a big booby trap, man. Don't fall for it.
Wake up, man. Come on, man.
Fighting over tissue like we ain't got bigger issues. Trump dropping missiles, water still dirty in Flint. But he made $2 trillion appear out of thin air. It's getting scary out here. Look myself in the mirror, I'm my only competition. Kinda hard when you black, gotta carry out the vision. And they always put you back, it's a fact. Then they wonder why he mad. Picking up and gun and blast, tell him chill. Get some wisdom in a book, get some paper in the hills. Bring it all back to the hood, to the homie case appeal. That's real. Real is when you lift your people up in the field. No matter how you feel, they really tryna kill us out here.
Children locked in cages, GMOs,
concepts, hey,
race,
to kill us out here.
Global warming, the media corrupt news outlets.
They trying to kill us out here.
Every time I turn on the news, whenever I look up, it's us versus them.
Hey look, they trying to kill us out here.
Telling y'all, they really trying to kill us out here.
They really trying to kill us out here. They really trying to kill us. They really trying to kill us
out here.
Yeah.
So if it's just three of us, man, and there's 100 of them, man, we're going to take back this church, man.
I ain't scared of nothing.
You scared of
nothing. The Bible says God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind.
Well, let's go.
I'm a leader, come straight feature. Lyrics over beats, Lord said to every creature. Overcame sin, showed us how to win. We ain't gonna fall for that false doctrine. We're here to let it flow, gonna let them know. King of the jungle just like Gorilla Joe. But I'm Mighty John, stomping out the spine. Disrespecting deities like a polygon. Turn up the treble to another level. He's hard of hearing, that dumb devil. But I'm a victor, electric like Thor. The battle's been won, so we don't have to keep score. Need a weapon, here you go. Oh, it's right here, we'll steal the show. Oh, lift your voice and start to spray. Hey, name of Jesus all dang day. Hey, need a weapon, here you go. Oh, this right here, we'll steal the show. Oh, lift your voice and start to spray. Hey, name of Jesus all dang day. Hey,
the fire. Always fit on tracks. I know you heard us do it, but not like that. Stay kingdom rapping, Jesus Christ kids. God's anointed coming out the basement. Always show love, never show hate. That's what you do, better stay, stay, stay. Around these parts, we lift up God. Let me show you how it's not that hard. Speak every day into existence. Overflow of favor, case you missed it. Standing with my squad, we stay praising God. Let me show you how it's not that hard.
Need a weapon, here you go. Oh, it's right here, we'll steal the show. Oh, lift your voice and start to spray. Hey, name of Jesus all dang day. Hey, need a weapon, here you go. Oh, this right here, we'll steal the show. Oh, lift your voice and start to spray. Hey, name of Jesus all dang day. Hey.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. I ride it to the block, but the hood, don't listen. To busy popping glocks and robbing and stealing. Don't wanna reach for help until their kids come up missing. I stay strapped with mine, I call it the gospel. No weapons formed against me shall prosper. How long we gonna play the game of sin? We officiate. Nobody ever wins in the game, so we depreciate. Even the celebrity world, it's the same thing. Talking about millionaires on killing campaigns. Yeah, I've been there and done that, so I call it like I see it. Everybody on earth will have to answer the name of Jesus. Robbing and stealing, I did it. Prisons and jails, I did it. Hood drug sales, yeah, I did it. Jesus came and saved, now I get it. Pray every day, now I get it. He died on the cross, yeah, I get it. My life in his hands and he flipped it. Can't believe I did it.
Hey, we are back here on the Hot Seat with IC Jonez. I am Deacon T, and I'm here today to talk to you about the hot topic, which today is, are you seeing people through the eyes of God? You know, our first guest today, Mr. Perfect, was talking about how God didn't make mistakes when he made people. And then later in the interview, IC was talking about, you know, why are we always talking down to each other and how unnecessary that is. And it dovetailed right into what I was going to talk about today. You know, in the Bible, there's a verse that says, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. Well, all of us as children of God are God's anointed people, all of us. And when we talk to people in a certain kind of way, or see them in a certain kind of way, we are going against what God told us to do. But just as important, we're continuing to perpetuate problems, stereotypes, and issues within the people that live in the communities that we all live in. When we look at people, how do we see them? Do we look at their exterior and make judgments about them? When we look at them, do we look at their haircut, their hairstyle, the clothes they wear, the kind of jewelry they have on, and make decisions about who they are as people? If we make those decisions, we all know that if we have a stereotype in our mind about who somebody is, then we respond and talk to them according to that stereotype. All that is wrong, and this is what I'm here to talk to you about today. We need to see each other in the same way that God sees us. So we need to see each other through the eyes of God. God doesn't see me as a screw up just because I have screwed up. God doesn't see me as an inmate just because I spent some time in jail. God doesn't see me as a drug addict just because I may have been addicted to drugs. God sees me all the time. And what I'm asking you to do is to see this same way. God sees me all the time as a person with potential, as a person he loves, as a person he cares about, as a person who he knows has everything inside of them they need to be fantastic, to be great, to be wonderful. But we as a society are so quick to judge people, to look at them a certain kind of way based on how they appear to us, instead of looking past the exterior, looking past their skin, looking past their skin color, looking past their sex, looking past their sexual orientation, looking past their style or their flair, and looking at, into the soul and the heart of the person. And realizing that just like me, no one's perfect. I'm the furthest person from perfect. And I don't want people judging me. I don't want people seeing me a certain kind of way just because I might look a certain kind of way. You know what? I might be wearing this outfit because it's the only one I have. I may not have my hair looking perfect today because I didn't have the money to go get a haircut. I may not be talking like I went to all kinds of fancy schools like you, because I didn't have those opportunities. You know, so instead of looking at people, judging people, looking down on people, making assumptions and assertions about people based on how we see them, which is all wrong, we need to think about how God sees them. We need to look at people in the same way that we would want to be looked at. When I go out places, I don't want people to make decisions about me based on how I look. I don't want people to make assumptions about me and treat me a certain kind of way based on how they see me. I want them to look at me for who I truly am, in my core, in my soul. I'm a good person. I try to do good things for people. I don't always do right. I don't always do the right things. I'm not perfect. I am not even close to that, but I'm trying. I'm trying, and I hope I'm trying my best. That's how I'd like people to see me. And I would think that you would like people to see you that way. So what I'm asking you to do today is to stop prejudging people. Stop pre-qualifying people. Stop deciding up front who's a good person, who's not a good person. And instead make the assumption that we are all good persons because we are all made by God. What I'm not asking you to do is to keep getting hurt by the same people over and over. It's two different things. So if you have someone in your life who continually hurts you, continually does you dirty, continually doesn't do what's right to you, I'm not asking you to keep hanging out with them. I'm suggesting, in fact, that you get away from them. But that doesn't mean that when you think about them, when you talk about them, and when you judge them, you don't look at them and judge them as a child of God, as somebody who's just as imperfect as you, but in a different way. I know I've hurt people. I know I have. I know I've hurt people, some people repeatedly in my life, and I'm not proud of that. But how can I turn around if I've done that and then judge other people for doing the same thing? Again, I don't want to associate with them. That's just smart. but I don't want to judge them either. I don't want to look down at them. And I'm asking all of us in the community today to look at how we can lift each other up, to look at how we can come together as people, regardless of race, religion, our practices, our economic, our social backgrounds, who we came from, where we're going, and realize that whether you are the highest ranking person in your group or the lowest ranking person, that everyone in that group as a person has the same rank in the eyes of God. And we should treat everybody the same. We should treat everyone with dignity and respect. We should attempt to lift people up instead of beating people down. Most people are 98 or 99 or 99.9% good, and they have flaws like we all have. We can choose to focus on the flaws, or we can choose to focus on the positive. We can choose to focus on those few things they've done that we didn't like or that weren't right in their life, or we can choose to focus on that 99%. I'm asking you today to focus on the 99%, to focus on the good in people, to help people be better. Let's face it, when people like me, like you, get positive feedback, we tend to gravitate toward that. When we get negative feedback, we end up gravitating toward that. So if all I ever hear is negative feedback, don't be surprised when I start being a negative person. If, on the other hand, I'm constantly being reinforced and lifted up, or being told that, hey, I didn't like what you just did, but I love you as a person because you're my brother, that's going to have a totally different impact. So remember, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. We are all the anointed of God. We are all entitled to be treated with dignity and respect all the time, no matter what we've done, no matter who we are, no matter how we dress, no matter how we talk. No one of us is any better than anyone else in the eyes of God. So today I'm asking you, look at each other in the same way that God looks at you. Amen?
Amen.
If you like that word today, every Sunday at 10 o'clock on Room Service Radio, on Deacon Tom Moore on Facebook and YouTube, and on Deacon TLV on the Instagram, you can catch our podcasts. It takes about 45 minutes to 55 minutes. We have a little word. We have some uplifting words of encouragement. We tie them back to the Bible. We have a little prayer, and then we bounce. You don't have to get dressed up. It's all online. You can roll right out of bed in your PJs, and you can check us out. I'd love to have you there. It means the world to me. It really does. Before I go today, I got to tell you, I got my grandson with me, Mr. Nasir. He's here with me. Say, what's up?
What's up?
All right. I love y'all. I thank you for being here with us. I thank you for joining us on the Hot Seat every Thursday from 12 to 2 and every Friday from 12 to 2 on Room Service Radio, and follow IC Jonez on his all of his social media platforms at IC Jonez and at the Hot Seat with IC Jonez. It's fantastic. This brother is doing work in the community. He is practicing what he preaches. He is giving young artists and young entrepreneurs in our community an opportunity to have their voice heard. And I think it's a fantastic thing. So in that regard, we're going to close. I just want to thank you for hearing us, for being here every week with us. Our numbers are going up incredibly. If you'd like to get your product seen or heard, you can contact IC at any one of his platforms. We can put together advertisements for you and sponsorships. It's a great opportunity for us to help each other and to pull one and each other up by the bootstraps. Amen? Amen.
I told God take the pain away. He told me he ain't finished trying to operate. I told him he might hear from hell by your pain. Said he almost done, he about to make a way. I told God take the pain away.